Rix Flicks coming at you with another theme park adventure, this time from Universal's Islands of Adventure. I'm going to try to do something I've never done before here. Wish me luck. Before we begin, we publish theme park videos on this channel all the time, so hit that subscribe button and that bell notification button so you'll know when another video is ready for you to view. Now, before we actually step into the park, right behind me there, see that building, that little kiosk? That is the Will Call kiosk. And what were you picking up from the Will Call, Nikki?
Our HHN tickets.
Halloween Horror Nights.
Yes.
We ordered those online and we chose to pick them up here at the Will Call.
Yes.
So let's go over here and talk about them. So this year, as in previous years, we went with the Frequent Fear Plus.
Yes.
So what that means with this set of tickets, we can go the first weekend and the last weekend, and then every night in between, except Saturday nights.
Right.
This ticket does not include Saturday nights, but we will be here the first night. So look for me. I will be the only person wearing yellow.
Probably.
Everyone else will be wearing black.
Yes, like this.
Yeah, like your shirt. The upside down. Which reminds me, let's talk about some of the houses we're going to have here. Yes, senior Stranger Things upside down Jurassic Park mashup shirt found at a Rix Flicks store near you, actually online. Go check that out, myrixflicks.com. The confirmed houses we have so far are what, Nikki?
So far, it's Stranger Things, the Universal Monsters, Nightingale's Blood Pit, Depths of Fear, and the new Yeti Terror on the Yukon.
Just announced this week. So far, my little rumor list is looking good. I did have a Yeti on the rumor list. It was Swamp Yeti. This is a Yukon Yeti. But that's a win for me, picking the Yeti.
That's true. And I hope to goodness that it's a cold house.
Yes.
If it's a Yukon Yeti, it better be freezing in there.
You're darn right.
Especially September and October in Florida, it's hot.
And a couple of the other rumored houses, not confirmed, that was on my list to be as a rumor, we have Ghostbusters, House of 1,000 Corpses. Those are two of the other rumored houses, but we have a brand new rumor. And now, on to that new rumor. I hope this is true. We were talking about this just on our own, without any rumors.
Yeah.
It. My source has told me that they believe It is coming. The movie It is coming to Halloween Horror Nights as a house.
That would be insane, especially because I hate clowns. So that might be the scariest house. awesome though.
I so wish that this rumor is true. Stay tuned, let's hang on and see if it's true, but oh my God, that would be a great, great house. That could be the best house of the year if it's true.
Oh yeah, definitely. It'd be the scariest for me anyway.
Yeah, you don't like clowns.
No.
But regardless, even if that's not true, even if it is not coming, which I hope it does, it's going to be a great Halloween Horror Night season.
Yeah.
But wait, that's not all. Camera 2, otherwise known as Nikki, reminded me I do have rumored scare zones.
Oh yeah, these sound awesome.
Now these are like working titles, so the title may change, but we think the concept may stay the same. So first thing we have is what? Anarcade?
Yeah, exactly.
So it's a mashup between the words anarchy and like arcade. So we think it might be related to like some 80s arcade stuff.
Okay.
Then what else do we have?
Zombieland would be next.
Zombieland sounds pretty good.
Yeah. Something related to plastic surgery.
And that would be on like Hollywood Boulevard.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it does make
sense.
I like
it. That'd be pretty cool. Mm-hmm. Vikings.
The Vikings. Yep. Scare zone for the Vikings.
And then Rob Zombie inspired zone, which I think would be awesome. I bet you they'll play some awesome music in that one.
That would be cool. I bet that would be the one that they have in New York that usually has a stage or something.
Yeah.
So, again, these are rumors. I'm not afraid of rumors. I mean, I'm not invited to the media event, so you know what? I feel free to spread some rumors. This is just like, if I was meeting you guys at a coffee shop, this is what we'd be talking about. This ain't no media event. This is coffee shop talk. Okay, now that we have dispensed with the Halloween Horror Nights news and rumors, some of it was news, not just rumor, guys, we're going to walk into the park now. In addition to trying this new thing that's here, that I'm going to try for the first time, I think we should try to get on Hagrid's again.
I would love it. Honestly, we've only done it one time, so I'm excited. Let's try.
My mark would be 90 minutes. I would not mind waiting 90 minutes for Hagrid today.
All right, that's a deal.
And just as a reminder, I have mentioned this before, they are not opening the motorbike coaster first thing in the morning. That's usually midday. I've seen it open around 11, so that's when we're going to try to get on that ride. In addition to Hagrid's not opening first thing, I think the new thing I want to try today doesn't start right away either. So, let's go pick a ride, Nikki.
Fun! Yay! Let's start rides.
Yeah, let's start over in Marvel and see what we want to ride.
Okay.
Looking at the times on the board, we have the Hulk is 25 minutes, Spider-Man 10, Skull Island is 10. What's your poison, Nick?
Spider-Man and then Kong.
Let's do it.
I honestly wanted to go on Hulk today, but I don't know if I want to wait 25 minutes for it.
25 minutes. Boy, are you spoiled.
Hey!
There are people who wait like an hour for this ride, honey.
That's true.
Spoiled brat.
What?
Hey, to be honest, 25 minutes scared me away too. As we make our way to Spider-Man, looks like some of Marvel Island's getting a new paint job. Just as we got in line, I was like, this looks longer than 10 minutes. We got in line and they upped it to 20.
They doubled it. I was like, nope, we're out. Let's go to Kong, hurry up.
If I was gonna wait in the 20 minute range, I'd go in the hole.
All right, come on, let's go.
There's some more paint refresh going on as we're leaving Marvel Island. No time to stop and take a closer look. Nikki is rushing the Kong so they don't change the time on that one as well.
I was gonna say, how much you wanna bet that they change it and then we step up there again?
Is that why?
We're behind the curve on everything because of your filming.
Hey, that's vlog life right there.
Oh.
Well, the posted time is 10 minutes. Hopefully it won't change right after we pass through the opening gate. Not even a 5 minute wait. That was a walk-on for us. Good choice.
Yay!
Now, this was one I've grown to like. When it my very first time riding it, we had to wait like over an hour. I was like, eh. But over time, I've really, really grown to like this one.
Yeah, me too. I would agree.
Now, we always advise to sit in the back, so much so that Universal, they do not even allow front row seating anymore.
Yeah.
They do have seating in row two, which is still not so hot. I still recommend going to the back.
Yep.
And we have to mention the queue since we've talked about Halloween Horror Nights, Nikki.
Yeah, I was talking about this on the way when we were walking.
Now, within the queue, there's a couple spots for a scare actor to jump out and scare you.
Yes.
They weren't there this morning. I mean, it's kind of early.
No, but I get close to that area and my heart starts beating. Boom, 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 boom. Like, I get nervous and scared.
It's real dark because you're like in a cave or whatever.
Yes.
So it does have that Halloween Horror Night Scare House feel to it.
It does. So yeah, I mean, like, cause you never know if he's gonna be there or not. Yeah. So every single time I walk by that area, I'm like, I get nervous.
I do really enjoy it when they jump out and scare you.
I'm sure you do.
So I don't think we'll walk back to Me Ship the Olive to look for the Jurassic Park coaster. We can look some other places, like behind the Three Broomsticks or something.
We can head over there on the way out.
Yeah,
I don't mind.
Well, we'll see what's happening. I don't think there's going to be a lot happening, but we will peek at the action from some vantage point later on today. So we're walking through. And I'm asking Nikki, what would you like to do today? She goes, oh, it's your day, whatever. So I mentioned the river adventure here at Jurassic Park. Oh no, I don't want to get wet. Is it my day or not my day?
It's not your day then.
No, it's not. I forgot that if we have to do any water rides, you need like 48 hours notice, don't you?
Yeah, that's so understandable.
So it's not my day. Welcome to Jurassic Park.
It's so open. Oh my gosh, it makes me so sad. I know it's temporary. I'm sure that they will definitely put up more trees, but wow, it has completely changed the feel
of
this area.
This is the first time you've been here in person. You've seen my videos,
yeah,
but in person, pretty bare, right?
Yes, I mean, it's dramatically different. I'm shocked.
But the saving grace, there's a good photo op. Let's go over here. Well, it's only temporary, but I love this shot of T-Rex. Let's do a selfie for Instagram right now. And here we go, guys. Here is that Instagram photo. Down on the screen right now, you'll see my little handle. Go follow me, please. Quite the crowd. It's a 45-minute wait to meet Blue today. That's a pretty long wait for this one. Here is another nice photo op in Jurassic Park, but if you want to get the best spot, stand in the Hufflepuff box. So I'm walking back here behind the Discovery Center. This is the bridge that's open. I was just coming back this way to see if we've gone vertical yet. We haven't. Let's go to the Three Broomsticks, the little back porch area. Flight of the Hippogriff, 20 minutes, or Forbidden Journey 15. Which one do you want to do?
Let's do Forbidden Journey. We'll do single rider. Maybe it'll be faster.
Okay, let's try it out.
Well, the single rider line was a walk-on.
Yeah, and bonus, we got to ride together.
Oh yeah, we rode together. I love it when that happens.
Yeah.
Yes. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how sick did you get this time, Nikki? Because there's some motion sickness with this ride with us.
Yeah, so 10 being the worst?
Yeah, 10 is the worst.
Not like a 1 or a 2.
Oh, really? You did well. I was like a 4.
See, I have an empty stomach right now, so I don't know if that helps. I don't know.
Let's have the frog choir walk us over to Hagrid's. And bonus, I know all the words to this song. As you can see by the sign, not open yet, it is 10:30. Now, I did not ask when they were going to open because they won't give you a straight answer. But I did ask, what time did you open yesterday? Just to get a feel for what time they opened. Yesterday, they opened motorbike at 12:30. So we're still a couple hours away. So let's just walk around. Maybe that little special thing I want to try today is available. And maybe we get some lunch as well and circle back around here. This is one of the reasons why I came here today. In the Lost Continent, a new meet and greet. I'm doing this for the first time. She-Ra is here. Can I get a picture with She-Ra?
Yeah, she's so pretty.
I love that you're optimistic opening up. Go ahead.
Perfect.
That was my interaction with She-Ra. She asked what my superpower was. I froze. I said making people happy. And I did make her happy, so I guess it was working. No.
It's true.
I'm just trying to be positive. Now, I'm not sure why She-Ra's here. I know like Netflix, not Rixflix, but Netflix, they have a cartoon series. They had season one, I think they're starting season two of this She-Ra cartoon.
Yeah.
So, but I don't know the connection between like Universal and like She-Ra, but she's here, at least for now. So, come say hi. Okay, I guess we're gonna do it. We are in line for Hagrid's. It is 10:50 right now.
Yeah.
We have our provisions.
Yep.
Pretzels and cookies and water. Hopefully it'll last. 10 minutes later, we have bailed out of the line already.
Well, it's funny, we were sitting like
we're
in a little table kind of near the entrance, and people were just like so frazzled trying to get in there too. I don't know, it's like stressful. Are people finding it stressful? I don't know.
Well, the thing is, I have to edit. I don't normally film and edit in the same day, but
right.
I have to today. So I really don't have a couple of extra hours today.
Yeah, it's kind of a bummer.
That's the reason I'm using. We're not weak. We can have 10 minutes, really. People wait for hour, like 5 hours, and we give up after 10 minutes.
But it wasn't the reason.
It doesn't matter because I got what I wanted today, and that was She-Ra.
She-Ra and a cookie. Couldn't be better for Rick.
That makes a good day for Rick. On to me ship the olive for my aerial view of the Raptor coaster. Well, it's just dirt right now, but I promise you, once they start the real construction, this will be the place to check it out. One thing I do need to note that's different. Remember that tree? They did transplant it. They did move it. I was right about that.
They sure did. It's gone now.
I wonder where the final resting place will be. Somewhere in the front of the queue. I hope it's a cool looking tree.
Yeah, I do too. I really hope that they keep it and plant it someplace significant.
Okay guys, that's going to end our adventure for today. Pretty good fun, right? We rode a couple rides.
Yeah.
You know, I met She-Ra. That was pretty hot, right? And with that being said,
don't miss the magic, don't miss the fun.
Thanks for watching Rixflix, and now it's time to relax.
Well, before we get too relaxed, let me say thank you to those viewers who have visited our coffee page and helped support the channel through that. First off, I'd like to thank Randall, who is a longtime big supporter of the channel. Thank you for all you do, Randall. Next up, we have Robert, Paula, Xander, and Luna from Scotland. Thanks for the coffee, guys. Next up, we have Ryan, another friend of the channel. Thanks for the support, Ryan. And now, a big heartfelt thank you to Amy Adams, who is 850 strong. Thanks for watching and thanks for the support, Amy. And lastly, for today, we have Madison. Thanks for the coffee and butterbeer, Madison.